Number 10.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Okay, coming in at number 10, we have a line from the rapper Numbskull from the legendary West Coast rap group Lunas off the classic song, I Got Five On It.
Go get the S-T-I-D-E-S. Nevertheless, I'm hella fresh, rolling joints like a cigarette.
If you've never heard this song, I'm gonna advise you to listen to it right now. This has to be one of the smoothest rap songs of all time, and Lunas delivers incredible verses over a beat that was ahead of its time. And the hook is probably one of the most memorable hooks in hip hop history.
I got five on it, messing with that in the weed. I got five on it.
But with all that being said, there's a line in this song that's very suspect, and the line comes from the rapper Numbskull.
Let's go half on the side.
I take sacks to the face whenever I can.
Wait, what did he just say?
Take sacks to the face whenever I can.
You take sacks to the face whenever you can. Now I know that this song is about guys smoking bud, and the sack Numbskull is referring to is a sack of weed, but the way that he says it comes off as if he's bragging about a sexual male act that he often participates in.
I take sacks to the face whenever I can.
The main thing that makes this line suspect, in my opinion, is the word sack. Like, you can't play around with a word like that. And you definitely can't say that you take sacks to the face. I don't even think it's cool to even say that you smoke sacks. You know what? Fuck it. Just erase the word sack from your vocabulary. Number 9.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Sadly, this next line comes from one of my favorite rappers of all time. Back in the year 2000, a supergroup called Analog Brothers released a classic album called Pimp to Eat, which consisted of legendary rappers Ice-T, Mark Moog, and my second favorite rapper of all time, Kool Keith. Now, this is one of those albums that's ahead of its time. Like, if you were to listen to this album, you would think that it came out this year. That's just how futuristic it is. But on a track called So Bad, Kool Keith says something that's very questionable.
Keith Corbs, last name Bertman, don't wanna hurt men. While managers walk out, we jerk men.
I honestly don't know what to say about this. I mean, I guess he's saying when record label execs leave their office, he robs them for their money. But this can't be what he means, because this is what he says next.
I move up with thrust, that's right.
Wait, so not only are you jerking men, you're also thrusting them?
While managers walk out, we jerk men. I move up with thrust, that's right.
I don't think I can give Kool Keith the benefit of the doubt on this one. This shit is just downright gay. Number 8.
Y'all niggas are gay.
I think we all know how influential the Chronic album was. It set the bar of what a gangster rap album is supposed to sound like. The lyrics were hardcore, and Dr. Dre's production was probably some of his best production ever. You had his songs like Ain't Nothing But a G Thing.
It's like this and like that and like this, and it's like that and like this and like that, and
fucking with Dre Day.
Don't even respect your ass. That's why it's time for the doctor to check your ass, nigga.
And a whole lot more. Now, even though this is one of the most classic albums of all time, a lot of the lyrics were suspect as hell. Shit, on the song Fucking with Dre Day, they said a ton of gay shit.
Make it by down to the rope. Fucking me, now I'm fucking you, little hoe.
Play with my bone, would you, Timmy?
And I'ma snatch your ass from the backside
with my nuts on your tonsils.
See what I mean? But the track I wanna focus on is the intro, which was performed by Snoop Dogg.
Niggas who talk shit get dealt with real quick. So if you wanna take a trip to the road, let a nigga like Snoop Doggy Dogg know. Protected by niggas with big dicks, AKs, and 187 skills.
If you wanna come to the row, let a nigga like Snoop Dogg know. Protected by niggas with big dicks, AKs, and 187 skills. Like, what the hell is this supposed to mean? Like, if you come to Death Row Records, you're gonna get brutally raped and tortured? And why the hell is he mentioning the fact that his homies have big dicks? Like, how the hell would you know? I mean, the fact that he knows the sizes of his homeboy's penis is gay beyond belief. Number 7.
Y'all niggas are gay.
This next line comes from one of the most savage diss tracks of all time. Back in 1998, Cannabis released a diss track called Second Round KO aimed at LL Cool J.
You want me to let the world know the truth? You don't want me to shine. You study my rhyme, then you lay your vocals at the mine. That's a bitch move, something that a rapper would do.
In the diss track, Cannabis lyrically destroys LL Cool J with the sickest bars possible. Now, although this is hands down one of the best diss tracks of all time, there is a line line that many of us question when we hear this song, and that line is,
well, let me tell you something, you might got more cash than me, but you ain't got the skills to eat a nigga's ass like me.
Now let's take a look at this rap lyric and try to figure out other ways to interpret it. Okay, I got nothing. Now I agree with the line that Cannabis said previously, as he mentions that it doesn't matter how much money the other person has, because all that really matters is who has more skill. But what the hell kind of skill is Cannabis talking about? By looking at this rap lyric, I believe he's talking about the skill of eating another man's ass.
Well, let me tell you something, you might got more cash than me, but you ain't got the skills to eat a nigga's ass like me.
Like, there are so many things he could have said in this line so that it wouldn't come off as gay. He could have said, I don't know, you ain't got the skills to rip a nigga in half like me. You ain't got the skill to put your foot in a nigga's ass. I mean, something other than eat a nigga ass, because that shit just don't sound right. Number six.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Redman is probably the most underrated rapper of all time. Like, this guy's lyrical ability is like none other, and the album Muddy Waters showcases his lyricism very well. To quickly sum up this album, it's basically Red spitting raw lyrics over raw beats. But on the track title Yes Yes Y'all, Red possibly says one of the gayest rap lines ever.
Get off my dick and tell your bitch to come here. Male groupies getting shaky when I come from the rear.
I really don't understand why he said this, because in the previous line he's asking the dude to bring him his girlfriend.
Get off my dick and tell your bitch to come here.
And then he proceeds with, male groupies get shaky when I come from the rear. Like, why the hell are your male fans getting nervous when you're coming behind them? Like, what the hell are you about to do? Like, I can't think of what else he might be talking about other than some sort of homosexual act. Number 5.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Back in the late 90s, DMX was a powerhouse artist. He is probably the only rapper that had two albums go platinum in the same year. And one of those two albums was called And Then There Was X, that included hit songs like Party Up.
I'm gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here, y'all gonna make me go all out.
And What They Really Want featuring Cisco.
Somebody let me know.
Although this is a classic album, there are a lot of instances where DMX says some straight up suspect shit. And one example is from the song What's My Name.
Suck my dick. And all you niggas that been to jail before know that it's about to get thick.
Wait, whoa. Did this nigga just have a flashback when he did time on Rikers Island? Now look, I've never been to jail before, so I probably don't know what it means when he says that it's about to get thick. But I might have a clue because of what he said previously.
Suck my dick.
But what makes it even worse is what he says next.
Let's get it on, baby.
Now I'm pretty sure we all know what the hell that means. And when you put it all together.
Suck my dick. All you niggas that been to jail before know that it's about to get thick. Let's get it on, baby.
It looks as though DMX is about to get on some prison yard gay shit. Number 4.
Y'all niggas are gay.
This next line comes from the classic track Aerial Codes with Ludacris and Nate Dogg.
I got hoes.
This has to be one of the most pimpish hip-hop songs ever, as Ludacris delivers clever rhymes while Nate Dogg brings a smooth melody. Now, for a song that's about hoes, you wouldn't expect any homosexual references, but Luda says something in this song that's extremely suspect.
314-201, too much green, too much fun, I Bangkok in Bangkok.
Wait, you do what in Bangkok?
I Bangkok in Bangkok.
Okay. If this song is supposed to be about women, why the hell is this dude talking about banging cock? The last time I checked, the word cock refers to the male reproductive organ, not the females. And then he says that he can't stop banging cock as he turns around and hits the same spot.
I bang cock and bang cock. Can't stop, I turn and hit the same spot.
I don't know about anyone else, but I can't listen to this song the same anymore after hearing this line. Number 3.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Okay, this next one comes from one of the most iconic rappers of all time. And the man I'm talking about is the Notorious B.I.G.
Who
the hell is this? Paging me at 5:46 in the morning, crack of dawning.
Now I know a lot of you are shocked right now, and I will be too if I didn't know that Biggie said some gay shit in one of his songs. But it's definitely true. In the song Me and My Bitch, Biggie says one of the gayest lines in hip hop history.
When I met you, I admit my first thoughts was a trick. You look so good, huh? I suck on your daddy's dick.
Hold up, wait a minute, time out. If your girl is fine, why the hell would you suck her daddy's dick? Now I know he's saying this because his girlfriend is extremely attractive, but it still doesn't explain why he would perform oral sex on her father. I mean, why not just perform oral sex on her? He could have said some shit like, "You look so good, I can suck your clit." He could have even switched out her father and just said that he would do her mother. I mean, anything but putting another man's penis in your mouth.
"You look so good, huh? I suck on your daddy's dick."
Now this right here is definitely one of the gayest rap lyrics ever, and it only gets worse. Number 2.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Okay, the rapper coming up shouldn't come as a surprise when talking about the issue of faggotry. Like, this dude is known for doing gay shit. Do y'all remember that video of the Cash Money concert where they were having a back that ass up contest, and instead of calling girls on the stage, Birdman decided to just call all dudes to come on stage?
"I need a fire high girl to come up here and twerk up. Bag that motherfucker up. I'ma show you what type nigga I am, right? These niggas right here been bucking with me all night. Let I want y'all to come here. Up here and fuck with me. Fuck with me. Fuck with me."
Look at this bullshit. Like, they're supposed to be having a shake that ass contest, which is supposed to just involve women. But Birdman decides to gather up a bunch of dudes, all while screaming,
"I fuck with niggas too."
All right, now that we know what this guy is capable of when it comes to gay shit, let's just get into the rap lyric.
"I like my dicks up fast. I like to fuck him in the ass while he beat up the pussy."
Yeah, you heard that shit correctly. He said he's going to have anal sex with the man while the man he's fucking is having sex with the woman. These niggas gonna be stacked on top of each other like one big gay peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Like, I don't think there's another way to interpret this. He just blatantly says this shit.
"I like to fuck him in the ass while he beat up the pussy."
Like, there's no way of getting around this. This line is simply gay as shit. Number 1.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Coming in at number 1, we have a line from another Savage diss track. Back in the early 90s, DJ Quick would feud with MC8 over gang-related issues. During the beef, DJ Quick released a diss track called Dollars and Cents, where he completely destroys MC8. There are so many things wrong with these rap lyrics, I don't know where to begin. First off, he says that he's never received oral sex from a man before. My question is, why the fuck would you want that? And why are you so curious? Then he says he wants MC8 to tell him how his penis tastes. I don't even have to explain how gay this shit is. And lastly, he says that before he ejaculates, he's gonna R. Kelly on his face. Like, what kind of sick shit is this? And how is this shit considered gangster? This shit is just borderline gay.
Gay ass nigga.
Alright you guys, that's the end of the countdown. Let me know what you thought about this countdown in the comment section below. There will be a part 2 to this video, so stay tuned for another top 10 gayest rap lyrics. So yeah man, stay tuned for that. But until then, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next video. Gulleyboy signing out. Number 10.
Nigga, you gay.
Coming in at number 10, we have yet another suspect rap lyric from DJ Quick. If you guys didn't know, DJ Quick made the number 1 spot on the last video with the line from his diss track aimed at MC8 called Dollars and Cents. This time around, he has a gay lyric from yet another diss track aimed at Everlast called Can't Fuck With a Nigga. Just like Dollars and Cents, DJ Quick lyrically destroys Everlast with sick bars and clever wordplay. But there is a line in this song that will raise your eyebrows.
"Yeah, motherfucker, right back on your ass. I hear it in the bushes and I crept up through the grass. What you running for, bitch? You fake Irish faggot. You got a big booty, Everlast, let me tag it."
Okay. Not only are you looking at a man's ass, you also want to tag it? For those of you who don't know, tag it is another way of saying fornication. So as we can see by this rap lyric, DJ Quick is extremely attracted to Everlast's butt.
"You got a big booty,
everlasting and wants to stick his you know what in you know where.
You got a big booty everlast, let me tell you.
Sound like some gay shit to me.
Number 9.
Nigga, you gay.
Alright, this next line is about to shock you, as it comes from a rapper who many people claim the greatest rapper of all time. And that rapper is Tupac Shakur.
Picture perfect, I paint a perfect picture, bomb the hoochies with precision, my intentions to get richer with that and double OP.
Yeah, I know. I was shocked too when I found this out. The lyric comes from a song called Thug Nature, which is a remake of Michael Jackson's song, Human Nature. The weird thing about this is Michael Jackson also has questionable lines in his version as well.
None of that is human nature, why? Does he do me that way?
What? Why does he do you that way? And what the hell kind of shit is this? But anyway, let's get into what Pac stated on his version of the song.
Little ecstasy, Hennessy, mixed with me. Picture me, pay for pussy, bring the dicks for free.
Did this dude just say, why bother paying for sex with a woman when he can just get a man's penis for free?
Picture me, pay for pussy, bring the dicks for free.
And what he says next just makes it even worse.
Hey now, where my niggas at? Tell these hoes.
This some old gangsta-licious homies over hoes type shit.
Homies over hoes, you do the homie, you do the homie.
Picture me, pay for pussy, bring the dicks for free.
Sound like some gay shit to me.
Number 8.
Nigga, you gay.
Now, sadly, we have another suspect line from one of my favorite rappers. Kool Keith makes the countdown once again with the suspect lyric from the song Sex Style. Now, Kool Keith says a lot of gay shit on this song. Let me just play a few lines just so you know what I mean.
Nigga, suck my dick and they girls drink my pee. You on the mic and when you rhyme, I start to jerk off.
You see what I mean? But the lyric I'm talking about is just flat out gay.
I see him seizing my face with they ass up. Let me put my cape on, my rubber and my mask up.
Okay, here we have Kool Keith in a situation where a man has his ass up, and what does he decide to do? Does he kick the man in the ass? Does he shoot the man in the ass with a gun? No, he doesn't do any of those things. What he does instead is put on a fucking cape, a rubber, and a mask. Like, what the hell does he plan to do with all these things? It sounds like he about to get on some real kinky shit with the male MC.
I see him seizing my face with their ass up. Let me put my cape on, my rubber, and my mask up.
That's gay.
Number 7.
Nigga, you gay.
Okay, this next one comes from the legendary rock group Nerd from their hit song from back in 2002 called Rockstar.
You think the way you live's okay.
I definitely remember this song from back in 2002. It was on a game called NFL Fever, and it was the main song that played on that game. I must have heard it like a million times, because I played the hell out of this game. But when I used to hear this song, there was a line that I've always questioned.
Wait, what the hell did this nigga just say? Did he just say that he swallows guys?
Yep, y'all heard that shit correctly. This dude just said that he swallows guys. Like, you don't put the words swallow and guys in the same sentence. You just don't.
You ain't heard that we swallow guys.
Nah, man. I ain't heard that y'all niggas swallow guys. And I don't want to hear that shit.
Number 6.
Nigga, you gay.
This next line comes from the Young Jadakiss on the classic track Last Day featuring the Notorious B.I.G. Now, I shouldn't even have to mention how lyrical this dude is. Even back then on the locks, this dude was a monster when he hopped on the track. And to be on the same song with another super lyrical MC, you can't go wrong. But on this song, Jadakiss says something that's very suspect.
Tearing you out is senseless. Perhaps, for instance, I give this faggot a French kiss.
I mean, if that's what you want to do, then go right ahead. I just think it's a little weird for a straight man to say he's gonna French kiss a gay guy.
So I give this faggot a French kiss.
Like, does this guy even know what a French kiss is? He would literally have to put his tongue in another man's mouth. But like I said, if that's what you want to do, then man, so be it.
Number 5.
Nigga, you gay.
In the early 90s, Crab Mac and Bad Boy Records had the game on lock. The release of his debut album, Project Funk the World, sold millions, and the hit song, Flavor in Your Ear, was high up on the charts for some time.
Here comes a brand new flavor in your ear. Time for new flavor in your ear.
Craig Mack was also a really dope artist, and I believe his lyricism is very underrated in the hip-hop community. But with all that being said, on a song called Making Moves with Puff, Craig Mack possibly says one of the most suspect lyrics ever.
I'm not the greatest rapper known to man. Got MCs melting in my mouth and not inside my hand.
This man literally just said MCs are melting in his mouth. Now I'm not sure if there's another way for a man to melt in your mouth other than a sexual act that involves ejaculation. Like, why the hell are you saying that men melt in your mouth instead of your hand? I honestly think this dude didn't proofread his lines, nor does he understand what the term melt in your mouth means.
Got MCs melting in my mouth and not inside my hand.
That's gay.
Number 4.
Nigga, you gay.
Now this next artist is known for saying a bunch of gay shit in his lyrics. He says so much gay shit that I could probably make a whole episode with his lyrics alone. For those of you who aren't sure of who I'm talking about the rap god himself, Eminem.
Beginning to feel like a rap god, all my people from the front to the back, knock.
This guy has a catalog of gay lyrics, but on this episode, we're gonna use a lyric that's really light compared to his other lyrics. The line comes from a legendary song called Bitch Please Part 2.
Yeah, what up Detroit?
No, he didn't. They didn't do it again.
This song featured Dr. Dre, Exhibit, Nate Dogg, and Snoop Dogg. This song is just amazing. Dre produces a sick beat, and everyone comes with awesome lyrics, and Nate Dogg kills the hook. But there is a super gay line in this song that involves both Eminem and Snoop Dogg.
The devil, they always want to dance.
Oh no, big slim dog, 80-pound ball, thick 6-inch long.
For those of you who didn't catch that, here we have Eminem explaining his genitalia, and Snoop Dogg is in the background going, yeah, like he wants it or some shit.
80-pound balls, thick 6-inch long.
There isn't really anything else to say about this lyric. Snoop just openly admitted to the world that he really loves the sight of Eminem's penis. And Eminem is just like, you goddamn right.
80-pound balls, thick 6-inch long.
Sound like some gay shit to me.
Number 3.
Nigga, you gay.
Now, I don't think that 2 Chainz is a terrible artist. I actually think he does pretty well on features. As for his solo efforts, I haven't really checked out anything. But someone brought this lyric to my attention as they believe that this is possibly the gayest rap lyric that has ever been said. The lyric comes from a song called Crack. And on this song, 2 Chainz basically invents his own slang by adding extra letters to words. Like, instead of saying crack, he says krenak. And instead of saying fuck, he says finnuck. But when he tries to put a twist on the female sex organ, it comes off very suspect.
Got it from the trap, now rap. No matter where I'm at, I got crack.
Shawty got some real good pinnas.
Wait, whoa. Shawty got some real good what? Pinnas. Bro, why didn't you proofread this shit? I know he was trying to put a twist on the word puss, but it came out like penis.
Shawty got some real good pinnas.
You gay.
Number 2.
Nigga, you gay.
Once again, the Notorious B.I.G. makes another appearance on the countdown. And this time around, he says something that's even more bizarre. On a freestyle called The Wickedest, Biggie makes many gay references. And he also reveals a scary prediction which involves a well-known DJ named Mr. C. Biggie starts off this track by saying this.
So anytime you're ready, Mr. C, we gonna get hardcore on these homos.
It's really weird that Biggie said this because years later, Mr. C would actually get hardcore on some homos. Back in 2013, it was revealed that Mr. C was having sexual relations with several transsexual men. It just makes you think if Biggie was also involved in these practices. Well, according to this freestyle, I would have to say yes, because Biggie says a ton of gay shit in this song. Like this, for example.
Biggie Smalls is the wickedest. Niggas say I'm pussy, I dare you to stick your dick in this.
You dare men to stick their penis inside you? Okay, if that's what you're into, I mean, that's what you're into, but it's pretty fucking gay. But this next line just seals the deal.
Niggas press their luck in, they get a butt fucking. Straight up the ass, raw dog with the rash, and I don't fuck with the condoms. The condoms is the problem from the AIDS getting sprayed. Diseases, big pleases, MCs across the seas, is just the way I clutch my prey, hey.
Alright. I'm convinced that this dude was a closet homosexual, because what straight man says this? This dude literally just said he's gonna butt fuck a group of guys with no condom. He also says that he's going to spread the AIDS virus as he is pleased to spread this disease. Bro, this dude is just sick out of his mind.
Number 1.
Nigga, you gay.
I never really understood the hype of the Migos. Like, every time I hear their music, the shit annoys the hell out of me. Many people say that their rap style comes from Lord Infamous, which I agree with 100%. But I believe they took Lord's rap style and completely shitted on it because these guys have no real lyricism and it just sounds like they're shouting the entire time. If you want to listen to rappers that perfected Lord Infamous rap style, I advise you to go listen to See the Six. But with all that being said, on a song called Young Niggas, a Migo member named Quavo says a really gay line that's very questionable.
100 round, call it drummer boy. Got a big ass tank, call it talking to it. Nah, you don't want no drummer boy. I eat a nigga ass like an almond joy.
You will eat a nigga's ass like an almond joy. Not only is this shit gay, it's also very disgusting. This dude just admitted to the world that he eats shit out of men's asses. Because if you don't know what an almond joy is, it's a chocolate candy bar that looks like a shit turd. And this guy flat out just said he's gonna eat a nigga ass like a candy bar that looks like a shit turd. No wonder I don't listen to these niggas.
I eat a nigga ass like an almond joy. My nigga, my nigga, my nigga.
Gay ass nigga, shut up. Oh, I ain't listening to you.
All right, you guys, that's the end of the countdown. Let me know what you thought about this shit in the comment section below. Like, dislike, do whatever the hell you want to do, man. But I'm going to see you guys on the next episode of Top 10 Gayest Rap Lyrics. That will be a part 3, so stay tuned for that. Until then, I'm going to catch you guys next time. Gulleyboy signing out.
I drip on your bitch like water. I splash on your bitch with the water. I feel like I'm 21 Savage. I pull up and fuck on your daughter.
Coming in at number 10, we have a questionable line from the prominent new school rapper Ugly God. On the track title LDC, which stands for Little Dick Click, Ugly God makes a track for those who are a little less fortunate downstairs. The song is somewhat uplifting, as Ugly God tells us no matter how small he is, he has no problem sleeping with attractive women. But the intro of this song tells a different tale.
Hey, hey. Hey, look at Ian back there, nigga. Dick getting hard by the song.
Okay, first of all, who is Ian? And why should we care about him getting an erection? What makes this worse is that Ugly God is saying that his male friend is getting this erection to a song called Little Dick Click. I mean, is the goal of this song supposed to uplift males with insecurities or to get their penises hard?
Hey, look at Ian back there, nigga. Dick getting hard by the song.
To be honest with y'all, I don't even know. Now, on the previous episodes of Suspect Rap Lyrics, there has been a hot debate on the term dick. A lot of people say when rappers refer to their rap counterparts as having big dicks, they're referring to the clip of a gun. Now, I don't know where y'all niggas from, but we don't say that shit in the Midwest. The way we describe a long clip is either clip or extendo. And I don't care how much y'all try to pass this shit off, the shit sounds gay. And most of the time, I honestly think some of these rappers are referring to their actual dick. Take this line from MC Ren, for example.
I heard a dope beat. Somebody told me that fuck did it, but if Dre didn't do it, I can't fuck with it. And WA is like a mix of fix the tricks, real niggas with big dicks.
Now, a lot of people are going to pass this off by saying MC Ren is talking about clips. Okay, if that were true, then why is he grabbing his genitalia? Throughout this whole music video, members of NWA are toting Desert Eagles, shotguns, revolvers, and a lot more weapons. But for this particular scene, Ren doesn't have a gun. I mean, if he was talking about a gun clip, why not show that? They showed all these other weapons. Like, what the hell?
Real niggas with big dicks.
That's gay.
Now let's fast forward to 2017. It seems like the new generation is still carrying on this questionable slang term. In the song Gospel, XXXTentacion says the unthinkable. Now, is it just me, or does this shit not make sense? I mean, if X was talking about a clip, why would he put the clip down the guy's throat? I guess you could say that he means he's letting off the clip, which is another way of saying that he's shooting the gun, but I don't think I've ever heard someone say that they're gonna shove a clip down someone's throat, because it doesn't make any sense. Like, why would you put the clip alone down someone's throat? All right. Real shit. All this calling a clip of a gun a dick needs to stop. Cause a lot of people not down with this kind of slang, including myself.
Thirsty, thirsty, trying to choose. I mean, I know I'm pretty cool.
Now, Chance is by far one of the most talented rappers of this generation. Each album he drops is creative and unique. My favorite project from Chance has to be Acid Rap, which featured the song called Everybody Something, where Chance tackles on the misfortunes of the youth while stating that everyone can overcome their struggles with faith. But just like Ugly God's song, Chance says something very questionable in the intro of this song.
On the mic like it's a dick.
I guess you can say that this is a clever line, because, well, the mic is shaped like a penis, and rappers oftentimes tell people to get off their dick.
On the mic like it's a dick.
No, bro, what the hell am I doing? Why am I trying to get a chance to pass on this shit? There are so many things you could have said other than being on a dick. I mean, come on now.
My trap on the couch like my legs broke. Catching cells, ain't no way I could be dead, bro.
Just like Chance the Rapper, Kevin Gates, in my opinion, is a top-tier artist of the new school. His southern slang alongside a sick flow and clever bars makes him one of my favorite rappers of the new school to date. In 2014, he collabed with another promising artist, Lil Bibby, on a track called We Are Strong.
Yeah, I'm that young nigga with the sick flow. They watching how I move cause they know I get dope. Posted on the block stunned with my kin folks. Nigga, you ain't talking money, what the fuck you here for?
And while listening to this track, Gates says something out of the ordinary.
Hey Gates, what should I start with him? I can tell these young boys ain't got no heart in them. Niggas funny, I don't even like to talk with them.
Me either, but we gotta play smart with them. Man, fuck them in the ass.
Now, a lot of people say that Gates is talking about finessing, which means talking someone out of their possessions. This will make sense, but after he said fuck him in the ass, he said we finessing for the check.
Man, fuck him in the ass, we finessing for the check.
Which means that these are two different things, which also means that this line is suspect as hell. What would have made this line not suspect is if he would have said something like, man, let's take these niggas cash, we finessing for the check, because fuck him in the ass just don't sound right.
Fuck him in the ass.
Please let's not go around referring to finessing as fucking niggas in the ass. I mean, the clip shit is bad enough.
Catch a dick in your throat.
Nigga, you gay.
Yo, dick. Stay up by my dick. Ball till I fall. Say what? Lost until I pay.
When the conversation of the best southern rappers come up, T.I. is a name that is often brought up. He has also proclaimed himself as the king of the South, with classic albums and a brand that produces a large sum of income. I believe he has the right to think so. But in 2007, T.I. would join Young Jeezy, Rick Ross, and Rocco on a remix to a song called I'ma Do Me, where T.I. sends shots at Ludacris and Shorty Love. But while he sends these shots, he says something extremely suspect.
Haters, I really mean, hey. Put this on anything. Hey. They say I start a lot of shit, I say I finish things. Just like some dental cream, I go in niggas' mouth, and like a limousine, I stretch a nigga out.
Now, I honestly can't find another way to interpret these lyrics. He said, just like dental cream, he goes in niggas' mouths. For those of you that don't know what it means when someone says they're going to cream in another person's mouth, they're usually talking about a sex act. And what makes matters worse is he says that he stretches dudes out like limousines. And when someone uses the term stretches, well, just go look the shit up.
Just like some dental cream, I go in niggas' mouth, and like a limousine, I stretch a nigga out.
Gay!
Cause it's mad, I get more butt than ashtrays. The fair one, I get mine the fast way.
Making his third appearance on this series, Biggie yet again says something extremely over the top. On the classic track Dreams, Biggie talks about all the R&B chicks in the early 90s he liked to have sex with. Now, you would think that a song about having sex with women, there would be no way he can say anything suspect. But just like his Bad Boy Offspring, Biggie comes through and says the gayest shit possible.
Same. I put Shanti more pussy in stitches. I fucked RuPaul before I fucked them ugly ass skate bitches.
Now, for those of you that don't know who RuPaul is, he's a famous drag queen. But most importantly, he is a man that Biggie said he'd fuck instead of females.
I fucked RuPaul before I fucked them ugly ass skate bitches.
Now, I don't know about y'all, but Candy and Tiny can get smashed. Even back then, they could get it. I honestly believe that Biggie really found RuPaul attractive and really wanted to smash him, because I find it really odd that he would say this on a song dedicated to women.
I fucked RuPaul before I fucked them ugly ass skate bitches.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Come here, little kitty, on my lap. Guess who's back with a brand new rap? And I don't mean rap as in a new case of child investigation accusation.
Okay. Okay, making his second appearance on this series, Eminem says one of the most over-the-top things in rap history. On a song called My Dad's Going Crazy, which shockingly features his young daughter, Eminem reveals something about him and Dre's relationship fans never saw coming.
I'm out the closet, I've been lying my ass off. All this time, me and Dre been fucking with hats off.
Okay, there is absolutely nothing suspect about these lyrics, because he literally said that him and Dr. Dre have unprotected sex, and Dr. Dre chimes in by telling him to suck his you-know-what.
All this time, me and Dre been fucking with hats off.
I mean, I have no problem with people coming out the closet. If that's what y'all do, then that's what y'all do. I'ma just leave it at that. Now, I'm gonna seriously need you guys to prepare yourselves for these next lyrics, because they're about to shock you.
I hop out the 6-4, cock the pistol, pop your kinfolks, shot your bitch blow. We're top to Frisco, then drop a 6-4 to shock your mental, I stop your menstrual.
For those of you who don't know, King Gordy is a horrorcore rapper that says the most grotesque things imaginable. And on the song titled Vader, he showcases just how sick he could be. Within this track, Gordy disses members of Odd Future because they denounced that they were not horrorcore artists. Gordy took offense to this by saying the gayest things imaginable.
Lord Vader, why are you such a hater? Why you always talking shit about Tyler the Creator? You just mad cause he made it and you didn't. This is sad, but actually, I wanna fuck Tyler in his ass. See, I'm in love with him. I wanna come at him and get him open. Then get my dick sucked by faggot ass Frankie Ocean. While the dyke girl DJ bites my pearl tongue 3 ways for 3 days, me and Wolfgang were each gay.
Okay, I honestly have nothing to say about this. This man just flat out said that he wants to have sex with Tyler the Creator and other things that I can't mention. So there's really no point in me trying to break these lyrics down or find another meaning, because I mean he said this shit. Ain't really nothing I can do.
I wanna fuck Tyler in his ass. See, I'm in love with him. I wanna come at him and get him open. Then get my dick sucked by faggot ass Frankie Ocean. While the dyke girl DJ bites my pearl tongue 3 ways for 3 days, me and Wolfgang were each gay.
But what makes matters even more worse, Tyler the Creator ended up responding to King Gordy with these suspect lines.
You don't want no problem, bitch. Oh, you gonna call the police? Well, give me your phone. I'ma use your anytime minutes. Dial my home number. You don't believe me, nigga? Just come see me, nigga. Come D me, nigga.
No! Oh! Oh!
No, I'm just playing. This wasn't a response to King Gordy. Just thought I'd throw this funny shit in here just to mess with y'all. Alright you guys, that's the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This right here was long overdue. And as always, if you like the video, smack that like button, comment your thoughts down below. And with that being said, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next video. Gulleyboy signing out. Coming in at number 10, we have someone who was long overdue for being on this list. Now, I'm not saying that 50 has a library of suspect lyrics, but he has quite a few. And in 2007, 50 Cent this Lil Wayne and Birdman on the track called Part-Time Lover. Now, the concept of this track is somewhat unique, as 50 disses Wayne and Birdman through conversations with his female companion. Sounds harmless, right? Well, that's until you hear the lyrics.
It's more than your body, baby. Damn, it's your brain. You make me wanna kiss you like baby kiss Wayne, and make you call me daddy like baby Dwayne.
Okay, now I know this is supposed to be a diss, but why is he thinking of two men kissing while getting intimate with this girl?
You make me wanna kiss you like baby kiss Wayne.
How often do you have dreams about men kissing?
That's a good ass question, Huey. Like 50, bro, explain yourself.
Damn, that shit sounds gay, it's insane.
Yeah, bro, you right. That shit sounds very gay. Well, I guess I'll give 50 a pass on this one, because I mean, at least he admitted it that it was gay.
Girl, your ass fat like Joe. You real sweet like Ja.
Wait, what? You know what? I'ma just take that pass back. Did he just say that this girl was sweet like Ja Rule?
That nigga's a sweetheart for real. Come here, give me a kiss, you little faggot.
Alright, alright, alright. I had enough of this shit. Let's just move on.
Fuck a beat. I was trying to beat a case. But I ain't beat that case, bitch. I did the race.
Okay, this next lyric comes from a rapper whose music I actually really like. Like, this man's music is so good, I kinda wish they would set him free so he could drop more music. Now, I know that's a pretty coonish thing for me to say, but if you watch my channel, then you should already know I don't give a shit about what you think. Anyway, just in case if you don't listen to Tay K's music, his subject matter oftentimes consists of selling drugs and killing people. And on a song called I Love My Chopper, Tay K opens up about his emotional and physical attachment with this gun by saying things like,
I don't tell no chopper, bitch, the chopper told me. I love my chopper and I think it love me.
But what he says next is borderline suspect.
Told FN if I sap his butt, I'm 16. He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
Hold up. Man, play that shit back.
He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
Okay, I guess I can kinda see where Tay K was going with this. Like, all he's really saying is that if a dude tries to act tough, he's going to shoot him with this chopper. But the way he says this is just weird. I don't think I've ever heard somebody say,
hey nigga, you think you hard? Don't let me make my chopper jack you off, nigga.
He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
No homo.
Boys talking down. Yeah, we call them haters. I'm balling right now, so we'll get to that later.
Young Jeezy is probably one of the most popular trap rappers of our time. His dedication to the culture has rewarded him with a cult-like fan base and an influencer within the trap music genre. And in 2006, he would collaborate with T.I., Young Dro, Big Country, and BG on a song called Top Back Remix. And on this song, Young Jeezy says something very questionable.
Hey, you gun Wednesday to drop that Monday. Ice cream and Bella, same color as a sun. So you can miss me with the hating in that. He can't rap shit. Tell them faggot ass niggas wrap their lips around my dick.
Bro, what? This man just said, yeah, all them gay niggas that's hating on me, tell them to come wrap their lips around my penis. I mean, you couldn't come up with the line less suspect? I mean, he could have easily said some shit like, and tell them faggot ass niggas, I keep a bad bitch. But instead, he would rather them to perform oral sex on him.
Tell them faggot ass niggas wrap their lips around my dick.
Nigga, you gay.
Big black nigga. In the icy watch, shoes on the coupe, bitch, I got a Nike shop.
Okay, the funny thing about this entry is that Rick Ross just made an appearance on the second part of my worst diss track series. And here he is again with another horrible diss track and a suspect rap lyric. Like, I can't make this shit up. Anyway, for those of you who don't know, between the years 2008 and 2009, 50 Cent and Rick Ross got into a very serious beef that led to multiple diss tracks. And I can proudly say that all of Rick Ross's diss tracks were complete garbage. And on a diss track called Push Him Over the Ledge, Rick Ross disses both 50 Cent and G-Unit and says the gayest shit imaginable.
Get money, homicide is what it come with. We the killers, motherfucker, who you gon' get? I handle homo solo.
Wait. You handle what solo?
I handle homo solo.
I mean, I don't think there's another way to interpret this. Like, anytime he's in the presence of a homosexual, he likes to handle them all by himself. And if you think this is bad, listen to what he says next.
Lloyd Blanks, I know you wonder why I ain't say nothing about your bitch ass, but you sucked your assistant dick on tape and he leaked it.
Hold on, bro. If this is true, how the hell would you know? Like, did you watch this so-called sex tape of Lloyd Banks and his assistant? Because if you did, boy, you gay as hell.
You're a fucking dick-sucking faggot. Niggas homos. Y'all could Google it.
Did this nigga just suggest that I go Google some gay shit? Man, get this nigga off my screen.
Baby, you been rolling solo. Time to get down with the team. The grass is greener on that other side, if you know what I mean.
Okay, before I get into this next lyric, I just gotta say that UGK is one of the most legendary rap duos of all time. Their contribution to the rap game has inspired many artists today, and their catalog of classic albums are still appreciated today. During UGK's career span, Pimp C passed away, rest in peace, and Bun B went to establish himself as a solo artist. But no matter how legendary you are, if you say some suspect shit, you're getting put on this list. And with that being said, on a track called Tell Me Something Good, Bun B says something completely out of the ordinary.
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Whoa. Did you really just ask another dude that question?
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Now, a lot of people might say that Bun B is referring to the guy having a gun, but I would have to disagree, only because of how he said it. He said it as if he really would like to know if the guy's really packing downstairs.
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Nah, man, I'm cool.
Chillin' with the homies, smellin' a bud, double parked
that I'm talking to Dub about who got a plan.
All right, just in case if you guys didn't know, Ice Cube is one of my top 10 favorite rappers of all time. The way he tells stories in his music is like no other, and his diss tracks are always deadly. And in my opinion, he has never lost a rap battle. Which brings me to this next lyric, which comes from the infamous diss track, No Vaseline.
Goddamn, I'm glad y'all set it off. Used to be hard, now you just wet and soft. First you was down with the AK.
Now, if you don't know the history behind this diss track, I will advise you to go do some research, or you could just watch the movie Straight Outta Compton. But with all that being said, there is a line in this track that's highly unusual.
The bigger the cap, the bigger the pillage. Who gives a fuck about a punk ass villain? You're getting cut real quick, an easy dick. It's smelling like MC Ren shit.
Wait. How the hell would you know what Eazy-E's penis smelled like? And secondly, how the hell would you know that Eazy-E's penis smelled like MC Ren's asshole?
An easy dick, it smelling like MC Ren shit.
Man, hold up, man, I don't do that gay shit now.
I beat a nigga's ass on the trenches for the hell of it. Damn, the motherfucking piece of pussy that's on television.
Okay, this next lyric ties in with the previous line from Ice Cube. Now, the NWA and Cube feud started because Ice Cube was not happy with his contract, which led other members to believe that he betrayed them. And one of those members was MC Ren.
Hey, yo, yo, this is MC Ren from NWA, and you back with me on Out West, you know what I'm saying? That fool Ice Cube put a diss on this record, yo. Hey, but why don't y'all tell him what we think about Ice Cube? You know what I'm saying? That's what time it is, you know what I'm saying?
Now, although one of his ways of venting his frustrations was gathering up his homeboys and punching buildings with the word ice written on them, he would also take to the studio. And on a skit called Message to Benedict Arnold, MC Ren tells listeners what him and his crew is going to do to Ice Cube when they see him. And in my opinion, it's one of the gayest things I've ever heard.
I smell pussy.
Yeah, nigga, when we see your ass, we gonna cut your hair off and fuck you with a broomstick.
Bruh, why couldn't you just stop at cutting a man's hair? Why you gotta be on that prison yard shit? Alright, let me ask y'all this. If a man isn't gay, would you think he would want to involve himself in a scenario like this? Because if you would, you got a little sugar in your tank. Nah, fuck that. Nigga, you got a whole lot of damn sugar in your tank.
Yeah, nigga, when we see your ass, we gonna cut your hair off and fuck you with a broomstick.
You know what I'm saying? That's what time it is, you know what I'm saying?
Pause.
Coming out the slums.
We have another suspect lyric that evolves around someone beefing with Ice Cube. In 1995, Cypress Hill would accuse Ice Cube of stealing lyrics from one of their songs. And when Cube found out that he'd been accused of this, he dissed Cypress Hill with a track called King of the Hill.
Every few years, niggas think they can deal with the real. Now I got to fuck Cypress Hill.
Cypress Hill then responded to Ice Cube with a diss track called Ice Cube Killer. And within this diss track, B-Real says something very suspect.
You can take the 4W fingers and stick it in Mac 10's ass and lick it. Ice Cube is a thing of the past. If I got no nuts, it's because they still smack in your ass.
Okay, you know what? I get it. B-Real is saying this because Ice Cube said that he had no nuts on King of the Hill.
You can't rap from the guts, and B-Real sounding like he got baby nuts.
The other reason why he's saying this is because Cube supposedly stole his lyrics. But no matter the reason, the shit still sounds wrong.
The King of Punks, King of Busters, King of Thieves. Now get down on your fucking knees.
Bow down.
Stop the sucking.
Save some for me, ass. Save some for me, dog. Come on.
Okay, now that's just gay.
Damn. Why they wanna stick me for my paper? Damn. Why they wanna stick me for my paper?
And making his fourth appearance on this series, we have another suspect rap lyric from the Notorious B.I.G. Like, what would this series be if this man wasn't on it? Anyway, this lyric comes from a track called Dead Wrong, which was released after Biggie's death.
Relax and take notes while I take totes of the marijuana smoke. Throw you in a choke, gun smoke, gun smoke.
This is one of Big's more popular songs, as the instrumental slaps hard and his wordplay and lyricism is top notch. And the remix also features Eminem, which makes for a deadly collaboration. But just like the majority of Biggie's tracks, he says some straight up off the wall suspect shit.
Slit the wrist the little sis after she sucked the dick. I stabbed a brother with the ice pick because he wanted me to fuck him from the back. But smalls don't get down like that. Found your father hiding in a room. Fucked him with the broom.
Okay, now for those of you who don't know, the premise of this verse is him going on a killing spree and killing anyone that crosses his path. So he stabbed the guy because he wanted to get duked in the ass, which Big then says he doesn't get down like that. Then he proceeds to fuck a man with a broomstick. Nigga, you just said you wasn't with that gay shit. Then you turn around and do some gay shit? Like, what the hell is this dude's problem?
Because he wanted me to fuck him from the back. But smalls don't get down like that. Got your father hiding in the room. Fucked him with the broom.
Gay shit.
My top back. Yeah, I got my top back. Oh my god. Ass pistols on my hips. Ain't got a cock stack.
Okay, coming in at the number one spot, we have a lyric from the living meme himself, Soulja Boy. Now, I don't really know the whole backstory behind this lyric, other than that Soulja Boy and famous Atlanta producer Zaytoven are close friends that helped each other elevate their careers. The lyric comes from a song called Phone Call, in which Soulja Boy shares some strange details about his relationship with Zaytoven.
Call all my fucking niggas up.
Call them niggas.
And tell them it's time to rhyme. See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga. I've been fucking him forever.
Bro, what the hell? This shit ain't even suspect. This shit right here is just downright gay. Like, this man literally just said he's been fucking another man forever. Like, damn, my nigga, forever? What kind of shit is that? Now, the thing that triggers me the most is the ad-lib that comes after the gay shit was said.
See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga, I've been fucking him forever.
Yeah.
This right here is a clear indication that he went back and heard the gay shit he said and approved it by adding the ad-lib. Like, did this dude have somebody in the studio with him to correct this shit? Shit. I guess not. And for that, he rightfully earns the number one spot on this list.
See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga. I've been fucking him forever.
Ooh, gay ass nigga. Shut up, shut up, shut up. Ooh, I ain't listening to you.
Alright you guys, that's the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, I'm gonna need you to smack that like button, comment your thoughts down below, and if you aren't subscribed already, man, go and hit that subscribe button, bruh, it's live over here. Now, if you made it to the end of this video, I got a very exclusive message for y'all. The next video that's gonna come out is Suspect Rap Lyrics 5. Yeah, you heard it right. Back-to-back Suspect Rap Lyric videos. So I'm gonna need you guys to stay tuned for that. It's probably gonna come out next week or some shit like that, because these right here take a lot of work to do. But with all that being said, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next installment of this series. Gulleyboy, signing out.
Around the bullshit like a matador. I'm used to the bullshit, it don't matter, boy. Corporate acquisitions, accumulations of wealth.
Alright, making this second appearance in this series, we have another suspect lyric from Curtis Jackson. This line comes from the infamous diss track released in 2005 called Piggy Bank.
Don't be screaming, get at me, dog. How you running for your life when I'm at your bar? I get the wave in that semi like it's legal.
In this song, 50 takes shots at Ja Rule, Fat Joe, Jadakiss, and many more. But while 50 attacks his rivals, something very strange is said in the middle of the second verse.
He don't want it with me, he in D.C. I can have a nigga run up on him with his shank. For just a few pennies out my piggy bank. Yeah, you'll bring the condoms, I'm in room 203.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Damn, brother. I ain't know you and Yayo got down like that.
Bring the condoms, I'm in room 203.
Now, some people might say that 50 is telling Yayo to bring condoms to his room so he can smash a girl, which is what the line after this implies.
Free bitch look like Kim before the surgery.
But I honestly think that's a cover-up, because the way 50 says this is as though him and Yayo are about to prepare for a midnight rendezvous.
Yeah, yo, bring the condoms, I'm in room 203.
Them niggas is ignorant.
I'm like, rah, rah, like I had cerebral palsy. My flow speed wet like all you girl draws be.
Redman is possibly one of the most unappreciated rappers of all time. His high level of skill within this genre is oftentimes overlooked for reasons unknown. One of his rap perks is being able to freestyle really well, which landed him on a mixtape produced by Funkmaster Flex called 60 Minutes of Funk Volume 2. And during this freestyle session, Redman says something completely out of the ordinary.
I got Tic Tacs in my mouth with a big dick.
Bro, Paul's no homo.
You said something gay, so you gotta say no homo, or else you's a homo.
Like, why the hell are you coming to a freestyle with those items in your mouth? Alright, I can give you a pass on the Tic Tacs, but that other thing you mentioned, I don't know about that one.
I got Tic Tacs in my mouth with a big dick.
No, in all honesty though, I could probably give Redman the pass because, well, he was freestyling, and he might have just slipped up. But we all know no matter what the situation is, if you say a suspect line, you're gonna end up on this series.
I got Tic Tacs in my mouth with a big dick.
Faggot.
Y'all know me, still the same OG, but I've been low-key, hated on.
by most these niggas with no cheese, no deals, and no G's.
Now, if you're a fan of hip-hop, then you should already know how influential Dr. Dre is. He's the co-founder of the rap group NWA, the owner of one of the biggest rap labels in the world, and he's a successful businessman. But let's not let that distract us from Dr. Dre saying some of the most suspect shit on his infamous diss track, Fucking With Dre Day.
Don't even respect your ass, that's why it's time for the doctor to check your ass, nigga. Used to be my homie, used to be my ace.
On this diss track, Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg send shots to Eazy-E, Tim Dogg, and Luke from the 2 Live crew. And throughout the song, both Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg recite some of the gayest lyrics imaginable. But the most notable lyric is what Dr. Dre states he would like to do to Luke.
Made you speak what you spoke, at yo, Dre.
What up?
Chip this nigga off, love.
If it ain't another hoe that I got to fuck with, gap teeth in your mouth so my dick's got to fit.
Bro, just because Luke got gap teeth doesn't mean you should just go stick your penis in his mouth, because I'm pretty sure he ain't with that shit.
Yo, gay ass motherfucker.
And what makes this line even worse is when Snoop Dogg follows up with this.
Whip my nuts on your tonsils.
Then they also say this crazy shit.
Now understand this, my nigga Dre can't be touched.
Luke's bending over,
so Luke's getting fucked.
Bro, what the hell are these dudes on? I mean, why don't they just come out and say that they're sexually attracted to Luke? Like, what the hell is up with all the subliminals?
Luke's bending over, so Luke's getting fucked. Whip my nuts on your tonsils. Gap teeth in your mouth so my dick's got to fit.
Yo, gay ass motherfucker.
Shorty screaming out she love me while bouncing it on me. She really don't like me, she just attracted the money.
Okay, now I know it's kind of awkward that Meek is on this list because of his current situation. I honestly wrote this segment a week before the whole fiasco of him getting sentenced, and I promise to God I didn't put this lyric in here on purpose. But anyway, this lyric comes from a song called I'm Killin', which ironically appears on a mixtape called Flamers. And I think that that may be the perfect name for this mixtape, because this line is some certified flamer shit.
That K is spinning nigga wheel, pants say jack. Abandoned house, with a tape back. Pool stick all in his ass, tell him take that.
Now I already know that many of you would dismiss this line by saying, that's from the movie In Too Deep. It's crazy cause nigga said the same thing when Biggie said this.
When I met you, I admit my first thoughts was a trick. You look so good, huh? I suck on your daddy's dick.
Bro, that's not gay. He just quoting the Richard Pryor joke. Let me tell y'all something. Just because these rappers reference the gay shit they say, doesn't make it less gay. Because that scene in In Too Deep with the pool stick is very fucking fruity.
Hey, go, man.
What?
Wildin' out, man.
Well, I'm wildin' out.
You supposed to be my
baby,
man.
Gay shit.
And with Meek Mill referencing this scene in his raps, makes it even more fruity.
Pool stick all in his ass. Tell him take that.
Oh, hell no.
It's been a long time since I hit you with freestyle, high-tech selection from the vaults of the Heights files.
This next line comes from one of the originators of gangster rap. In my opinion, Ice-T is another artist that doesn't get him no credit for inspiring artists such as N.W.A., Tupac, and many more. And in 1993, he will release one of his most classic tracks called 99 Problems.
I got a hoe from the east, got a hoe from the west, got to hold it like the jacket off and rub it in a chest.
Throughout this song, Ice-T describes the type of women he has, but his description of one of them is very questionable.
I got a bitch that's fast, a bitch that's slow, a bitch that's a virgin and a bitch that's a hoe, a bitch that lies, a bitch that's true, a bitch who's a man because that bitch is true.
Damn, OG. I mean, I knew you was a pimp, but I ain't know you was out here pimping them transsexuals.
A bitch is a man because that bitch is true.
Like, damn, my nigga, you didn't go back and listen to this shit after you said it? I guess there was no need for him to, because he said it with so much conviction as though he's proud to have a boyfriend on the side.
A bitch is a man because that bitch is true.
You gay.
Coming through the alley with the trunk fell, I found me, who's you? Who me? Oh, I be the one from back in the day.
For those of you that don't know, William Calhoun, aka WC, is a forefather of West Coast gangster rap, and is very well known for popularizing the dance craze known as crip walking.
Keep it gangster, y'all, keep it gangster. Keep it gangster, y'all, keep it gangster. Keep it gangster, y'all, keep it gangster.
He is also well known for teaming up with Ice Cube and Mac 10, forming the legendary West Coast rap group West Side Connection. During the time they released their debut album Bow Down, they were feud with Cypress Hill, Common, Q-Tip from A Tribe Called Quest, and many more. And on a song called Cross Them Out and Put a K, WC says something extremely gay in regarding A Tribe Called Quest member Q-Tip.
I once knew this bitch by the name of Q-Tip, who claimed he had a problem with this gangster shit. Behind closed doors, running his mouth like a drinking, took this nigga by the name of Dub, caught him slipping.
so many questions for this shit. First off, he said he was going to tie Q-Tip up, and out of all things to gag his mouth with, he chose a fucking apple. Okay, fruit strike number one. Then he said that he dug him out. Now I'm pretty sure some niggas gonna be in the comments saying, when he say dug his ass out, he talking about shooting him with a gun. Aw, nigga, fuck all that. Alright, fruit strike number two. And then to top off the gayness, he then said he shoved a cucumber up his ass. Like, why the hell would you do that? Man, what's up with these dudes and shoving items up dudes' asses? First it was a broomstick, then it was a pool stick, now we got a cucumber? Bro, I have no more words for this shit.
Turn his ass up and threw him in a truck. Put an apple in his mouth, then dug his ass out. About a month later, they found his body stashed in the trash bag with the cucumber in his ass.
No.
No. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. No. No. No, 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 hell no!
Snitches wanna try, snitches wanna lie, the snitches wonder why, snitches wanna die.
Okay, surprisingly, this is only DMX's second appearance on this series, because this guy is known for saying a ton of suspect shit in his lyrics. Anyway, this lyric comes from a track called Top Shotter, from the classic hood film Belly. This track also features Sean Paul and Mr. Vegas, as it has a real reggae feel too. But while on this song, DMX says something only niggas in prison can relate to.
Go for the bullshit, get out and down. And time is just too important to be fucking around. Chump nigga, I stop a mud hole in your face. Motherfucker, rip your butthole out of place.
Bro, what the hell? Like, what is up with all this anal penetration? Like, I never knew that this was a known torture method amongst these rappers. Like, this dude literally said he will whip your butthole out of place. Bro, let's just move on, because there is no way of getting around this shit.
Motherfucker, rip your butthole out of place.
I bet you're the kind of guy that would fuck a person in the ass and not even have the goddamn common courtesy to give him a reach around.
You see where this Kanye shit is getting us, right? Hashtag half a fag.
Now, many of you may know that Lord Jamar is that guy that gets interviewed on DJ Vlad. Well, before he was getting interviewed on Vlad, he was a member of the legendary rap group known as Brand Nubian.
You ain't get a hurts to be dumb, dumb, and blind. Supreme mind will take you out of your paralysis.
Brand Nubian is looked upon by many as being one of the greatest rap groups of all time, as their catalog consists of tons of classic songs, one of them being a track called Punks Jump Up to Get Beat Down, which is a hardcore track about whooping niggas at a train station.
One day when I was riding on the train, I seen these two kids talking about the Nubian rain had fallen.
But during this track, Lord Jamar slips up and says some off-the-wall suspect shit.
I might dig in your ass quick fast like my name was Flash.
Bro, I thought this song was about beating dudes up, not dicking niggas in the ass. Like, what the hell is this dude thinking? Another thing I find funny about this is when Lord Jamar is on DJ Vlad's platform, he's oftentimes accused of being homophobic. And you know what's crazy? So am I. And I really don't understand why. I mean, if you can't handle jokes, you need to get your sensitive ass off my channel. But anyway, people always call Lord Jamar homophobic. But there's no way that this dude is homophobic, because just in case you didn't hear it, listen to this shit again.
I might dig in your ass quick fast like my name was Flash.
Hashtag half a fag.
My life is all I have. My rhymes, my pen, my head. Yeah.
Now, if you guys have never heard of Pharoah Monch, I will advise you guys to research this guy ASAP. A lot of you people may know him from the classic hip-hop track Simon Says, which is played damn near everywhere.
We just in the back sipping yak, y'all, what's up? Girls, rub on your titty. Yeah, I said it, rub on your titty.
Okay, this is completely not related to the video, but I'm gonna seriously need you guys to check out all this dude's albums, especially We Are Renegades. But back to the subject at hand. Before Pharoah's solo career, he was a part of a rap group called Organized Confusion, which consists of himself and Prince Poe. Organized Confusion also dropped notable projects, one being called Stress, The Extinction Agenda. And on a song called Bring It On, Pharoah Monch recites yet another suspect rap lyric involving a man's rectum.
I even be getting more graphic than I need OGO 32-bit computer to be slipped between my lips, and then I'll spit it out, go ahead, spit it out. That itty bitty style you upchuck, better believe I butt fuck MCs from the rear.
Hey bro, to be real with y'all, I don't know if I can handle any more of these butt fucking lyrics. I mean, that's literally all this video has been.
Look
bitch bending over,
so looks getting fucked.
Pool stick all in his ass, tell him take that.
About a month later, they found his body stashed in the trash bag with the cucumber in his ass.
Motherfucker, rip your butthole out of place.
I might dick in your ass quick fast like my name was Flash.
Better believe I butt fuck MCs from the rear.
And what makes this lyric worse from all the others is that he tells us who exactly who he's gonna butt fuck.
Better believe I butt fuck MCs from the rear.
Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no, to the no, 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 no. Listen.
Who's the black sheep? What's the black sheep?
Alright, I feel like it's necessary for me to give you guys a lesson in hip-hop before I reveal this extremely gay lyric. It comes from a song from Showbiz and AG, which is a rap duo from the Bronx, New York, affiliated with the rap coalition known as the Diggin' in the Crates crew, which consisted of legendary rappers such as Lord Finesse, Fat Joe, Bug Wow, and the late great Big L. The song is called Bouncer This, which features Dres from Black Sheep, which is another rap duo from New York affiliated with the Native Tongues, A Tribe Called Quest, Jungle Brothers, and De La Soul. Okay, now that's enough history lesson. Like I said, the lyric comes from a song called Bouncer This off of Showbiz and AG's debut album Runaway Slave. And in my opinion, it's the gayest lyric on this list.
I just get off, not just that, yo. I say I do a good and shocking panel that we be in Hollywood. Don't get jail if we cash law checks, cause we skittle it dip, da doop, dip, dip, dip for effects. Brothers think I diss them, but I'm really on the dicks. Look into my album, kid, you'll see all the flicks.
Bro, not only did this man say that he was on brothers' dicks, he then proceeded to say that there is flicks of him doing this sexual act? Like, did this dude really just hop on the track promoting his X-rated movie? I think that's exactly what he did. Yeah, bruh, I don't see any other way of interpreting this shit. My man's just flat out laid all his personal info dead on the track.
Brothers think I diss him, but I'm really on the dicks. Look into my album, kid, you see all the flicks.
Dude, are you gay? Dude, it's not a big deal. You like to fuck guys. I'm cool with it. I got friends that fuck guys in jail.
Alright, you guys, that's the end of the video. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you smack that like button, comment your thoughts down below in the comment section, and if you made it this far in the video, I have a very special announcement for you guys. The next upload on this channel is going to be suspect rap lyric related. I told y'all there were going to be back-to-back suspect rap lyric videos, but this right here is going to be the last one I'm going to do for a while. Because I don't just want my channel to be fucking suspect rap lyrics. Like, I like making these videos, but then I don't want to be known for this shit. So after I drop this next one, it's gonna be a while before I drop another one. Just letting y'all know. So y'all might want to enjoy this shit now, because I'm about to get on some more realer shit with my videos, bro. Like, this shit finna get crazy. So with all that being said, I'm gonna catch you guys on the next installment of this series. Gulleyboy signing out.